Hi there, Serdar Yegelob here with InfoWorld.eg. Today in SmartPython, we'll be looking at the basics of the list collection type. Now, a list in Python is a collection of objects in a one-dimensional container, just a bunch of Python objects all in a row. Lists are best when you want to store things in a specific order, when you want to iterate through them in that order or in the reverse order, and when you want to access them by their position in the list, called an index, or when you want to get a random item from the list. Now, lists don't all have to contain the same kind of object. It's often useful for your own convenience if you do, but there's nothing that says they must. As you can see here, a list can contain any kind of Python object, including functions or module objects. If it's a Python object, it'll fit in a list. To access an item in a list, you use the item's index. This is a number starting at 0, so 0 always fetches the first item. For the second item, you use index 1, and so on and so forth. If you want to start from the end of the list and work backwards, use a negative index. This way you can always get the last item by just using minus 1 as the index. There's also more sophisticated indexing options for lists called slicing, but the slicing syntax is worth a whole video unto itself, so we'll skip that for now. Now, we hinted earlier that lists can also contain other lists. If you want to extract something from a list within a list, just put one index after the next. The name of the list object and its index extracts the sublist, and then the next index extracts the item itself from that sublist. Now, one common thing done with lists is iteration. This is when we traverse an entire list and do something with each element in it. Python has a common way to do this with any type of object that can be iterated through. It's called the for syntax. If we say for element in my list, the code block that follows will take each item in the list under the name element and let us perform some operation with it. We can also use the enumerate function with the list to step through the list and give us the index number of the current object along with the object itself. Lists have several built-in commands or methods that let you perform operations on the list. Append adds an element to the end of the list, and pop removes and returns the last element from a list. This makes it easy to build stack-like structures with lists, since appending and popping are very fast. You can also use insert, along with a location, to indicate an index point in the list where you want to add an item. And you can use pop with an index to pop an element from a specific index on the list. Now, a note about inserting or removing. If you insert or remove from a list anywhere but the end of the list, that's a potentially a much slower operation than just adding or removing from or to the end of the list. So if you're dealing with a list that has thousands or tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of items and you're constantly adding elements in the middle or at the beginning, or you're popping items out of the middle or the beginning, you're going to quickly find that things will be much slower than if you're just adding to or removing from the end. There's another object in Python called the double-ended queue that is more worth using in these scenarios, but we'll cover that in a different video as well. Now, you could also test for the presence of a given item in a list by simply using the syntax if item in list. But be warned that finding items in a list by anything other than their index can get very slow. When you say if item in list, the only way Python has to find the item is by traversing the entire list, checking each item, and quitting the minute it finds the item in question. Now, for really big collections of objects or many such searches repeated over and over again in a type loop, the search time can really add up. So to that end, the best way to test for membership, the presence of an object in a collection, is to use a dictionary or a set rather than a list. Now that's it for this basic intro to Python lists. We've got more videos diving deeper into the subject and how they're useful coming real soon. If you like this video, leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more smart Python videos, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.